Belmont. This is Hannah Fischer with your community calendar. Happy May. It's truly the most wonderful time of the year. The trees are blooming, the temperature is perfect, and there's a sense of anticipation around every corner. Sports are in full swing, seniors are in the throes of senioritis, and the first beach day is just within our grasp. That said, before you contemplate leaving our fair corner of the state for your summer adventures, take advantage of all of the fantastic community events that are happening this May and June, and there are truly a plethora from which to choose. On the heels of Earth Day, there's an eco-friendly and budget-friendly event to start out with. The Plymouth Congregational Church will hold a rummage sale on Friday, May 12th and Saturday, May 13th. Now is your chance to pick up some gardening supplies, clothes, children's items, and so much more. You never know what treasures are to be found at these events. Keep your eyes peeled for the next Antiques Roadshow item. Sticking with the eco-friendly theme, head on over to Belmont High School on Saturday, May 13th between 12:30 and 3 to help the BHS Climate Action Club plant a native garden. Restoring native plant habitats is vital to preserving biodiversity. By creating a native plant garden, we nurture and sustain the living landscape for birds and other animals. What a great opportunity to make an impact in your community. The Belmont Health Department is holding a COVID vaccine clinic on Monday, May 15th from 4 to 6 at Town Hall. It couldn't be easier to stay up to date on your vaccines. Simply register through the Belmont Health Department and show up for your appointment. Make way for the Belmont Voice, a new local newspaper is in the works. On Tuesday, May 17th at the Belmont Public Library Assembly Room, learn about what a dedicated group of volunteers is doing to bring a new voice to Belmont. Hear about their progress so far, about exciting volunteer opportunities, and give your opinions and ideas about how to make this new community asset meet the news needs of everyone in town. Can't make the event? No worries. It will be broadcast by Belmont Media Center Live. For additional information, visit belmontvoice.org. I couldn't have asked for a better segue for the next event. Extra, extra, read all about it. Newsies Junior is coming to Belmont, Mass. That's right, the Chenery Middle School will perform Newsies Junior from May 18th through 20th at the Belmont High School Auditorium. Based on the true events of the Newsboys strike of 1899, this historical account features amazing songs, energetic dances, and phenomenal performances. Don't forget to seize the day and purchase tickets to this family-friendly event at belmontpac.booktix.com. In the spirit of the season, the National Association for Armenian Studies and Research is holding a Literary Lights event featuring Susan Barba, editor of American Wildflowers, a literary field guide. This anthology is filled with classic and contemporary poems, essays, and letters inspired by wildflowers, perfect for writers, artists, and botanists alike. Moderated by Dr. Jesse S. Arlen, the inaugural postdoctoral research fellow in Armenian Christian Studies and director of the Krikor and Clara Zorov Information Center, this event takes place on May 17th at 7:30 p.m. at the Nassar, 395 Concord Avenue. No registration required. It's the event we have all been waiting for. That's right, it's the 32nd annual Belmont Town Day. On May 20th from 9 to 4, Leonard Street will be closed, starting at 7 a.m. for setup, and the streets will be filled with, well, people, of course, but also rides, games, community tables, delicious food stalls, music and dance performances, an antique car show, a plant sale, and so much more. There is something for everyone at this event. Just be sure to leave your car at home and put on your walking shoes. Oh, and season Town Day attendee advice here, bring a reusable bag for all the goodies, free and for sale, that you will inevitably head home with. The level of talent in our town never ceases to amaze me. If you can believe it, Belmont is home to a Chenery seventh grader who's written not one, but two books. Annalise Morellis, author of Swinging Lone and Field of Wishes, is the featured author at a Friends Author Series event at the Belmont Public Library. On Wednesday, May 24th, come hear Annalise discuss her books, the writing process, and what's next on her to write list. Annalise's books are geared towards the 9 to 14 age range, but I've read them, and they are fantastic for any age. Registration for this event is recommended. For additional information and to register, visit belmontpubliclibrary.net. For all those Indian cuisine lovers in Belmont, this next event is for you. On Thursday, May 25th at 7 p.m., Belmont Books will welcome Julia Child Best First Book Award winner, Maya Kaimal, author of Indian Flavor Every Day. This book proves it's possible to create your own culinary masterpieces with just a handful of essential ingredients. Ms. Kaimal will cover traditional dishes as well as many vegetarian and gluten-free recipes. My mouth is watering just looking at the recipes covered in this book. Roasted asparagus with tamarind and crispy shallots, anyone? Many Belmont residents spend time at the Mass Audubon's Habitat Education Center and Wildlife Sanctuary in the daytime, but do you know what goes on at night? Now is your opportunity to check out Evening at the Pond, an educational experience led by a habitat naturalist. On June 2nd, explore the area and find out what lives in and around the pond, and most importantly, see what comes out after the sun goes down. This event is appropriate for children ages 6 and up. Registration is required. Check out massaudubon.org for additional information. Calling all Bob Ross and Winslow Homer fans and Belmont's aspiring artists. Join local artist Adam Adkinson and learn how to paint city scenes using watercolor techniques. Adam will break down elements like buildings, people, lighting, cars, and much more into easy-to-learn pieces. While the class is set in a studio, you will learn techniques that you can take out into the field. This class, run through the Belmont Recreation Department on June 3rd, will set you on the path to creating your own masterpiece. Registration is required at belmontmass.myrec.com. June is Pride Month, and there's a wonderful celebration taking place in Belmont. On Saturday, June 17th, the LGBTQ Alliance is sponsoring a Pride March and celebration. Gather at the Belmont Town Green, 440 Concord Avenue at 1245, and set off at 1 p.m. to march along a new route, changed to be a shorter, flatter, and accessible route. After the parade, there will be a gathering at Trinktish and a celebration of Fran Ewan, the founder of the LGBTQ Alliance. For more information, visit belmontlgbt.com. The Belmont Human Rights Commission and Watertown Community for Black Lives are jointly hosting a two-day Juneteenth celebration on Saturday, June 17th from 9 to 1 at the Watertown Free Public Library and Sunday, June 18th from 2 to 6 at the Beach Street Center in Townfield. These events will be filled with entertainment, food, DJ, Kids Corner, free ice cream, and much more. In addition to being Asian American and Pacific Islander Month, May is also Mental Health Awareness Month. Here to discuss two related events are Belmont Pan-Asian Coalition Vice President Laura Germain and Dipali Trivedi, BPAC board member. Welcome, Laura and Dipali.
Thank you. Thank you for having us.
Thanks for having us.
Thank you. So Dipali, I'm going to start with you. And I was hoping you could tell us about the Belmont Pan-Asian Coalition Dance Fest at Town Day on May 20th, which I am so excited for. And I can't wait to hear about the event.
Yes, this is our second year doing this. Last year we did it and more than 100 people attended that and we saw great response. So we are going to do that again. It is at 10:15 in the morning. So stop by if you are there at Belmont Town Day. But there are three set of performances. There's a first dance by Akriti Dance School. This is a Kathak dance. It's a classical Indian dance that was actually used more for storytelling. There's a second dance group. It's a Belmont Bollywood group. It's run by Dipti and Sulagna, Belmont residents. And kids are going to perform Bollywood dances that you generally see in Indian movies, right? It's actually based on folk dances and some element of classical dance, but it's generally what you see in Indian movies there in India. And then the third is by Vaibhava Dance Academy. It's a Bharatnatyam dance. It's a classical dance actually originated from Hindu temples, doing the storytelling about the god Shiva mainly, and then other storytelling of Mahabharata or Ramayana. So there's a diverse set of dances that you can enjoy if you stop by at 10:15.
Excellent. And what's the age range of the students who are performing?
That is a fun age. It's like it starts from like 8 up to 13 or 14. So you will see all spectrum of like, you know, different girls performing.
Fantastic. And where are these dancers, where are they taking their classes or how are they getting involved in this performance?
Yeah, so there are two dance academies performing. One is Belmont resident Umi Samadar is running from here and Deepa is in Indore. And then two Belmont moms, Dipti and Sulagna, spin up this Bollywood dance group and gather all these kids and like running with it and doing this for fun, right? Because they're passionate about dancing. So there are two dance academies and then Belmont moms running with their passion.
Fantastic. And do you all know, is the stage, if I'm remembering correctly, is it right in the center? Will we be able to get in there and get close? And you said it's from 10:15 to about when would you say?
10:15 to 11:15.
Wonderful. Fantastic. Thank you so much. I know I have, I think I was there last year when you all performed, and I'm looking forward to it again this year. So thank you.
You can't miss us. We will, kids will be in vibrant, colorful attire, so you will not miss.
Excellent. Great. So now I'm hoping to chat with Lori a little bit. And I know that this is, as I mentioned, Mental Health Awareness Month. And I was hoping you could tell us about the social media campaign that you are running to increase awareness of the particular challenges facing the Asian American community in Belmont and everywhere.
Yeah, so Belmont Pan-Asia Coalition throughout the month of May will be putting up messages and facts and information about mental health that is general as well, but also things that are specific to the Pan-Asian, Asian American community in Belmont and then the United States more broadly. I think there is a perception that is based on a lot of stereotypes and the model minority myth that the problems of mental health are less in the Asian American community because it's a community that's seen as high achieving, where there are close-knit communities within it. But actually, amongst in the United States, Asian Americans are the least likely to seek mental health treatment, despite the fact that they have similar levels of symptoms of other racial ethnic groups. It's the highest of any racial group in the United States, the amount of non-treatment seeking. And in fact, you know, the model minority myth plays into this. There's this idea that because these Asian communities are often seen as higher performing, that therefore, you know, the stigma around mental health, you're supposed to be really someone who doesn't have a lot of problems, who supports your community. And those stereotypes are one of the reasons why Asian Americans don't seek treatment as much as they should. We see in our own Belmont schools, based on the 2021 Youth Behavior Risk Survey, that in fact, suicide planning is highest among Asian American students in our schools. So, you know, these are not kids who are doing great compared to other kids, right? So not to say that Asian American health is more important than mental health amongst other groups, but it's something that we really want to shine a light on because it's often neglected, often seen as being less of a problem than I think it really is, and being able to give our communities and our kids the sort of help and attention they really need and deserve as much as anyone else.
Right. And could you give me a few specifics about things that you might be doing either in conjunction with the Belmont Public Schools or through your social media campaign?
Yeah, so we've been sending out flyers and messaging to the Belmont schools. We did a survey in the high school on May 5th that we got some great feedback from amongst the high school students themselves. And we'll be sharing messages about every 3 to 4 days on Facebook, on Twitter. So Facebook is the Belmont Pan-Asian Coalition Facebook group or the Facebook page that folks can join or follow. On Twitter, we're at Belmont Pan-Asian. We'll be posting that, I think, probably on screen during this. So folks can follow there. And then a lot of the messaging is oriented around resources. It's oriented around, you know, what do you do in the case of someone being suicidal? You know, where can you learn more about the way things like anti-Asian racism and stereotyping and the unique challenges of our communities really play into mental health? And that's not just for people who are Asian American in Belmont, but people, you know, in general, right? So allies of the Asian American community too. So it's not just for those who identify as Asian American.
Okay. Great, thank you. And we will make sure then that we put all of this information on the screen and direct folks to this important information that you all are putting out. And thank you for putting all this together. I think it sounds like something that is very needed. And I hope that a lot of people go to your site and look at the information. And then hopefully there are places from which they can get additional information if needed after they've read.
And we appreciate your support in spreading the word too. Okay.
Well, thank you all so much.
Thank you.
That's it for this edition of the Belmont Community Calendar. If you would like to see your event featured on this program, please email event details to access@belmontmedia.org. Thank you. And now, here's a list of upcoming Belmont meetings that Belmont Media Center will air.